The calendar has turned to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in Week 13. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Fires that quickly outside and past the 40 before he's out of bounds. That was a lightning fast decision that time. He just caught it, got rid of it.
Because he saw his guy was going to be open immediately. So he took the R, the run, out of the play. He took the O, the option, out of the play, and immediately got to the pass.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. So their task a little bit more difficult now, second and 13 that they're walking up on. Now he dumps this off over the middle, and he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 43. On play action, love to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there, nearly an opening drive, INT.
Absolutely no disguise on that one. They just went for it, put him out there and said, go deep, let's try and hit him. Unfortunately, to no avail.
Second and 10. Now Love. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 28. He's able to get six, a nice pickup down to the 21. Well, this defense for the Jaguars, they were excellent in that win over the 49ers last week.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there, and they came away with three interceptions in that game.
The last run got six, now second and four. They hand this off to Harris. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Now a give, running left is Harris. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
The keeper nets him only a yard, and that's going to bring up fourth. Fourth and inches, they're going to want to talk this over. We get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now a field goal forthcoming for the Steelers. This is an easy one, 23-yarder. And his kick is indeed good. And the Steelers will jump out to a 3-0 lead. Well, after marching down the field, only getting three there, kind of feels like a win for the defense.
And it does. They'll go to the sideline feeling a lot better that they didn't give up a touchdown after the march against them. But if I were the offense, I wouldn't hang my head over that one. That's a good drive, and 3 points were put on the board.
First carry for the Clemson man, Travis Etienne. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead him to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. First carry of the ball game now. It's C.J. Anderson. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
On first and 10, it's Etienne. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. So back-to-back big runs picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Clock running, under a minute to go now here in a fast-moving first quarter. On second down, a run with Etienne. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation we were talking about with one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly, it's a big man's game. It's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
And just one tick to go, so this will obviously be the final play of this first quarter. Following the penalty, Anderson. Yeah, he'll be forced to dive forward just to get back to the line of scrimmage. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. Here's second and 10. Now a give, running right is Anderson. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about three. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
This will be the eighth play of the drive. It's third and seven. From the gun, it's Jackson. Buying time to his left. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
Now that's disappointing for the defense. They had the advantage, had excellent coverage all over the field, but they let him get away, scramble, and pick up a first down and inside the 5-yard line.
Etienne will score. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment. That allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But you also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again. 2nd and 10 from the 25. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Working out of the gun. Love. And he finds Howard complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play. After that throw, and it was definitely one that he would love to have back, I wonder what's going through his head. I wonder what kind of mind game he's playing with himself to get himself back on track. Because a lot of guys, that's what they do. They have little triggers that when the mechanics are off, if they make a bad throw, that they go to that place to get themselves back in sync.
And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 21. They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in 6. In good position, 1st and 10. And he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well. So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
On the give, this is Harris. Oh, now Harris lost it. It's a fumble. And the Jags grab it. Look at this. Middle of the field. A breakaway. Past the 20. And he brings this one back. A fumble return for a Jacksonville score. Even the great ones, some of the best, they're not immune to the fumble, and here it really hurts them.
If the ball gets away from any runner's body, that's when the defense pokes at it, swipes at it, swats at it, and finds a way to create a big play for themselves.
Extra point by Bass, up and good, and that pushes the lead up to 11. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This one fielded at the 5. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a 1st and 10. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. Play action this time with Love. toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Out of the shotgun, it's Love. And this heads straight to the sideline. I don't think they're going to let him get away with that. Nope, they won't. Here comes the flag. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
On second down, this is Harris. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 42 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
Well, it looks like they caught him off guard on second and very long by running the football. All right, we always talk about tendency breakers and counters and doing things opposite the grain, and that worked very well for him. Picked up really nice yardage, but he still have a lot of work to do on third down.
And that is incomplete. Had a defender right there to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game, because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They'll start on the ground, ETN. And a nice pickup there as he'll get about 9, and that will lead us to a stoppage here at the 2-minute warning. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. On second down, ETN once more. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things, isn't he? But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on out there. And right now, he is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat in every meeting with reporters? This week, he kind of said, I've had enough, and I don't blame him. He looks like a guy that may very well be out the door.
After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. And now Jackson will look to throw it. Going up top. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive as they'll take over with just under a minute left to play until the break. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. Good push up front and then a run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they're able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Love, they go play action now. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack. Josh Allen, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Not one. another sack. They'll play it safe with a run. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32. Obviously well short of the first down. The Steelers send out their punter now as he'll kick it away for the second time. Fielded at the 20. A good kick that time, but also a pretty good 15-yard return. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes inbounds. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately.
Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. So we hit the halftime break here in Jacksonville with the Jags on top. As we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Jaguars in possession of the lead, and they will get the football as we are underway in this second half. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. He'll have a first down past the 40. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Jaguars! A big play there. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Bass. Up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. From the six. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a second and 3, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They'll keep it on the ground. Harris again. Got some room at the 30. Room here to run. And powering through at the 35. And he winds up getting this all the way down to the Jags' 31-yard line. 116 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Play fake. Here's Love. Out to the left there and complete to Howard. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Here's Harris. And he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Love from the gun. Touchdown! A great play there. His 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers are able to cut into that deficit.
The big fellow was the recipient there for that touchdown pass, and it seems like more and more the tight end is the guy you have to worry about most in the passing game.
Point after, right down the middle. And that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up.
It got his man complete. Touchdown, Jaguars. DJ Chark with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead. I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use in that, man. One play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent. Talk about explosive. 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
This one fielded at the 5. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And now last drive, so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number.
There he goes, left side. He's at the 40, 20, 10. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Najee Harris, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers are able to close the gap just a bit. Extra point splits the uprights. And that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now ETN to start the drive. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable 3rd and 7. Jackson. And Chark hauls it in. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the 3rd quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. They'll try to run with ETN. And they'll take this one in for a Jags touchdown. Travis ETN with his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the Jaguars get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead. The extra point by Bass, up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Parker, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've...
Ball comes out, and the Jags grab it.
Well, if these guys wanted to get back in this game, they needed an almost perfect second half, and down three scores, a lost fumble here certainly doesn't fit into that plan.
That reminds me of my plan in college to get an A on the papers I turned in, but that didn't work out too well either. Too many mistakes by both of us. I mean, that's just pure and simple. And that's why that's exactly where they are in this ball game. They're going to need a huge turnaround if they want to try and win this one.
Yeah, boy, now you see him, now you don't. Excellent move, nice run, winds up getting about six. Another tote for ETN. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 49 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot. They go play action with Jackson, and they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. They'll wind up losing eight on the sack there, and it's second down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. From the gun, Jackson. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's gonna lead to third down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It'll be a loss of 6 yards on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down. The kick by Bass is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
Remember, they have won three straight, but getting to four straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hole.
And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Off the play fake, Love. That's caught by Howard.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work. And that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Love now. He finds his man complete. That's Howard. 5 yards remain on second down. They'll run. Here's Harris. They follow up the gain of five by only getting one there on second down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And he's got his man in stride, complete.
And he will have a Steelers first down by about a yard. It's a gain of five on third and four.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Defensively, you look at the numbers, another incomplete pass that we just saw, and they're under 200 yards passing for the game, so they've done their job on that side of the ball.
Yeah, recently I was actually working a game where a quarterback had a streak of five straight games without a 200-yard game, and that was the big talk, both in his town and amongst his team. How do we get the passing game going? So big credit to them, holding them under 200 today.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Going back to Love. And the Jags get to him as down he goes. Jalen Phillips with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven. Indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Jags take over in terrific field position. First down. Here's the run with Anderson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. They push him back 8 yards that time on second down.
The Jaguars on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 19.
Now it's Jackson. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up fourth down. Here's Jamie Gillen now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. He's going to field this at the 4. 45 yards, that's what the punt goes for. 5 on the return. And the Steelers are going to take over first and 10 deep in their own territory. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Even though they were able to force the punt defensively, still a big hole to climb out of, especially at this late stage of the contest. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score.
The Loves throw complete here, pulled in by Howard.
That'll give them 8 that time, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And this is going to be a Steelers first down as he'll get this up to the 25. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On first and 10, Love. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. To pass, here's Jordan Love. Flush to his right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Here's Love. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. Throwing. Love. He finds his man complete. It's Howard. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Again, it's Love. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they
and into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. They're going to run it with Harris. And he'll get in for the score. And that's going to cut the lead down to 13. So 2 scores down. Time definitely not an ally. But here comes the onside kick. And the Jaguars are going to cover this one up. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Fellas, we knew even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. And the Steeler pressured too much here. He's going down. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just a shade under a minute to go in the game. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. A give running right, ETN. And he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants.
Touchdown, Jaguars! A big play there. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars are looking to make it 2 straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. So the Jags will keep the offense out there as they'll decide to go for 2. Down to a knee for the Jags. Victory seemingly in hand. And he is not going to get in there. He stops short of the goal line, and the lead is going to stay right where it is. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay. Offensive penalty has us back where we started as they come up on a first and 10. They hand this off to Harris. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5.
Easier when they're scoring that many points allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Jaguars, they continue to make their case for the playoffs as they move to 9-3, and they will hit the road next week to take on the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, for the Steelers, it's a tough one to swallow as they drop back to 8-4 on the year. And they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in Cincinnati against the Bengals. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.
Talking about making industry music. They want me to cop to y'all, but ain't gon' cop to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog basketball. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That chicken, he talking big hit. I was
kicking in houses for it. Got two different tickets, right?